Eight on Your Side investigates a shocking find in one community.
Two pipe bomb style devices buried on their property. Pinellas Park police did respond to the Sunny Rest Mobile Home Park. That's near 78th Avenue and 40th Street on New Year's Eve. Investigative reporter Masa Saidi is joining us now live from the scene with more on the story. Masa, how scary for a lot of those neighbors out there?
Yeah, Rod Mal, very scary situation. These homes are so close to each other. So if the bombs that had been located right there would have gone off, this could have potentially been catastrophic.
They found the pipe bombs behind this?
Yeah, because they're going to put electrical box in there for the trailers.
Here's the view of the Sunny Rest Mobile Home Park from above on Drone 8. You can see the homes that surround the strip are tightly packed next to each other. Multiple witnesses tell 8 on Your Side investigates that the two pipe bomb-style devices were buried here. Neighbors say that this lot had been vacant for months.
It looked, you know, something off TV or something.
Tonight, no information has been released about the pipe bomb suspect. Some witnesses are so anxious they didn't want to be identified. Detectives say a maintenance worker discovered the devices buried here about 3 feet deep.
And you talked with the maintenance worker?
Yeah, he showed it to me first. I was the first person to see it. The black one had the fuse coming out of the side. The other one had the fuse coming out of the top.
We can't show you pictures of the pipe bombs. Detectives tell us they didn't take any because they were so concerned about detonation. Tonight, 8 on Your Side investigates is looking into who had access to this property.
But the guy that used to live here, he committed suicide, this guy did.
Don and Denise Westover have lived here close to a decade, and they believe they know who could potentially be capable of making a bomb.
A couple of years ago, there was a really problematic tenant, and you saw a lot of strange things.
Yes.
This guy was really crazy.
He had all kinds of guns and ammunition.
So we have been speaking with folks here. We did get some names of potential suspects. We're going to continue looking into who could potentially be behind this. And Rod, of course, police are doing that as well.
What's the status out there right now? Has this whole thing been cleared up?
Yeah, it has. Police searched this entire area. They have removed the devices. And I'm also in touch with the owner of this property. He wants to stress that this community is now safe.
Very interesting story. All right, Masa Saidi reporting live in Pinellas Park Forest. Thanks.